All right, so welcome to another Triplo AI video. Today is a different video. Now you can see me. As you have been saying that you like my videos, I decided to invest some money on equipment, and this is the result. I hope you enjoy it. Without further ado, let's talk about what's important. So let's talk about these latest two releases of Triplo AI. The former last one, a mobile, version 3.2.2, fairly small release addressing two important bugs that we noticed. First one was Anthropic integration that was broken, and the second one, long form generation that was being cut. But this is a fairly small release for mobile, and be sure we're working on a major to revamp things and fix lots of and deliver improvements that we know that should be delivered. But let's focus on 3.5.0 for desktops. And this is a very important release, and I want to share this with you. You must have noticed that we developed Triplo AI in waves, where we have like these major versions where we bring these killer features, new stuff. And then in the middle, we bring these minor releases where we not only fix the bugs that we created, but also we address things that you asked us. And this is especially the case of 3.5.0, where we are bringing lots of things that you asked us. So let me go through each one of these improvements, and I'll show you where it is on your Triplo AI. So let me clear my screen here. And first things first, let's talk about the German localization. And now if you jump into your settings, you can select German or Deutsch, I think. I know nothing about German, and I want to share with you that this only happened because someone came to us and said, I want to have Triplo AI in German. I want to translate the interface if you allow me to do so. And of course, we accepted. And now we have also two kind guys working, one in French, the other one in the Italian versions. And if you want to do the same for your mother language, feel free to reach out and we'll guide you, even maybe reward you for that. But that's something that we can do together, okay? Let me switch back to English. And in this very same screen, you see that now we are masking the API keys and the key. So better privacy for you, better recordings for me, less work. And we also added these tooltips on all of the switches here, so you know what they do, so it's clearer for you. And we also added this new switch. So this one addresses the shift backspace on the main input field, where if you hit it, it will clear Triplo AI, so you can start fresh. Some doesn't like it, so now you can use this switch. Also here, if you jump into voices, you see that now you may select different and new voices. So we added them here. And also you can select the playback speed. So if you want to rush your audio generation, you can do it now with Triplo AI. Also, let me jump into these like main features. On each one of them, we added a path for documentation. So here on smart prompts, and under instructions and under automation, and it's easier for you to find this good path. One thing that I forgot, now if you come to Triplo AI to activate a key and you face that admin thing that prevents you to register, you can reset the device key association right through your current clients. So either under device, the device's screen, or here on the input key field, you have the chance to reset your devices. So we are working on this to make it easier for you. This is an important step, I believe. So on the main interface, now you see that if you prompt something, let's say, hi, Triplo AI, once the generation happens, you now have this new button, reprompt. And this is very useful if you're working with like complex prompts and if you want to test and try and refine things. So if you hit it here, you'll see that it will copy the former prompts to the input field and you can work, hi, Triplo AI, how are you today? and you can improve your prompts from this. Be aware that we are not carrying anything that you selected on your awareness feature. So we are not carrying context or selection. And if you want to use it, you have to select it again. And also, if you use it files in the former prompt, you have to add the files again, because we don't like leaving that on memory for unused time. So every time that you hit enter to prompt, it's gone and your privacy is protected and all this kind of stuff. It's very useful. I know you like it. Also, regarding the files, if you add a file now, you notice that now we deliver an estimation of the size of in tokens of the file. So this is the way where you can be aware of how heavy the file is and if you're like consuming too many tokens using these files. Very simple and useful thing. Also, under history, we now have deletion confirmation, because sometimes we push the wrong buttons and now you must confirm that you don't want to keep that that on your log, okay? And the other thing you'll notice is that now we have the models that were used for that generation also registered in your history. Know that if you're like me, switching models in the middle of chats, we'll register the last model used on that chat. This is important, so you know. I believe I covered everything. Oh, well, of course, we do have interface fixes of minor fixes of the interface and also security enhancement. There's always someone trying to exploit our tokens and this kind of stuff. But this is kind of funny and challenging at the same time. Let me head back to my screen and play once more with my buttons. Let's see if I hit the right button. Oh, yes, I did. This is the Big Felipe. And thank you very much. Thank you for your support. If you have any questions, drop us a message here on the video or on our Facebook group, or drop me a message at support@triplo.ai. It's always a pleasure. Take care. Bye-bye.